Hi there, I'm Lee Reeder. I'm a compost specialist with the Lane County Master Gardeners, and I'm going to explain this contraption behind me, which is a three-bin hot composting system. This is one way to do hot composting, and it's for people who have a lot of material available as well as the space to have something like this. As you can see, there are three compartments. One, two, three. They are built with removable slats on the front so that you can access the material inside. They're also built on the sides with, I don't know if you can see this, but there are sides made out of hardware cloth, and that's to allow air to circulate freely inside with the materials. That's really important in a compost pile. Let me put this back. Also, these are, they contain a volume of 1 cubic yard. So that's 3 feet by 3 feet by 3 feet. And that's important because when you fill one of these bins with material, that volume will create enough internal heat to assist in efficient decomposition of the material. And that's what you want, of course, in a compost pile. And the whole point of doing a hot compost pile is to do it fast so that you can churn out lots of compost for your garden. But I got some pretty good plans that I found online. They were easy to follow, and so I made it, even though I'm not really a carpenter. So if I can do it, anybody can do it. The way that you use this type of system is one bin at a time. You fill one side with your materials, and then you monitor the internal temperature with a thermometer. As time goes by, usually about a week, the internal temperature will climb and then it'll start to fall. When it starts to fall after about a week, then it's time to turn the pile. So you turn that pile into the second bin. At that point, you can build a new pile in the first bin and you start that process all over again if you've got the materials to do it. And then after another week passes, the internal temperature of both piles is starting to fall. Then this one is moved to the third bin, and the first bin is moved to the second bin. So then if you're really into this, you can build a third pile in your first bin, and you just continue that process of every week turning and until you reach until you reach the third bin, and by that time the material should be decomposed sufficiently that you can take it out of here and put it into a different container to cure for several weeks. And once it's cured, then you can spread it on your garden. So if you're doing this very efficiently, you can turn out finished composts in maybe 2 or 2.5 months.
The container that's used for curing should have a lid on it, but it doesn't need to be aerated the way this does. In fact, you want to maintain moisture in it because that keeps microbes and other little critters alive, and that's what makes compost so healthy for your garden, is all that microbial life in it. So that's the main thing, is to keep it moist.
Hello, I'm Kathleen Daly, and I am a compost specialist. And what I'm going to do is tell you a little bit about the ingredients that we have here in 5-gallon buckets that we're going to use to build our compost pile. So we have veg matter, all vegetable waste of all kinds, and we've got in these buckets. We have leaves, and there's a very different an important difference between leaves, straw, paper, and the veg waste. And that is that the veg waste is mostly green, or what we consider green matter, because it's fresh and therefore more nitrogen heavy. Whereas the leaves, straw, and shredded paper have all been dead a very long time and are therefore more carbon concentrated than nitrogen concentrated. The other component that we have in these two bins are coffee grounds. And though coffee grounds look dark and like they're not green, they are very definitely green because they came from beans of coffee that were alive not very long ago. So this is also considered a green nutrient. It's so concentrated that we use it in place of manure if we do not have manure available. That would be the other component that we do not have here. So those are the components that we're working with today.
So we have a layer of leaves in the three bin system on the left. And so now we're going to take the veg waste. And then we're going to add coffee. Yeah, we're going to do a coffee grounds, which is a green also, as we explained. And now we're going to add another layer of green material, veg waste. So now we're going to go with a layer of the carbon source. So we've got, we have leaves,
well,
and straw and shredded paper.
Let's do like handfuls of each.
Okay.
And then there'll be more. More mixed. We're mixing the paper especially so that it doesn't get all matted up like paper mache. Leaves, and then I'll mix it with the fork.
Now we're just taking a manure fork and mixing the brown materials together so they kind of give good pore space so the compost pile can breathe. Alright, we've got that nicely mixed, and now we will add another layer of veg waste and coffee grounds. Now we have some coffee grounds going in with the veg waste. And another layer of the veg waste. So we're going to start with another layer of brown of mixing the straw and paper. We're just mixing it up a little so that the paper intermixes with the straw, and the straw can be in clumps a little bit too, so just breaking it open. When it comes from a compressed bale straw, it sometimes stays compacted in, and you want to have it open and airy. And now a layer of leaves.
Mm-hmm. We'll make a third bucket of brown.
Oops. Stirring it a little bit.
Okay. Can we do another veg?
With the leaves? Sure. So we're going to continue on building up with veg, coffee grounds, and leaves, alternating those layers of the greens and the browns as we go up. And
okay.
You want to talk about the size?
Yeah, so part of it is if there's large pieces, we're just breaking it up a little bit so that it's not just going to be a solid mass of green material.
And the volume?
3 cubic feet?
And the volume of the bin, what you're looking for is a space that's 3 feet by 3 feet by 3 feet, which makes it a cubic
yard.
Yard.
You want some more leaves?
Yeah.
So I'll get some more.
It's a good idea to end with carbon, just because it helps keep down flies and other insects that will enjoy feasting on this.
Final bucket of leaves. Hot compost, you're looking at trying to, in the next few days, reach up between 131 and 160. And here Lee has the compost thermometer that she's going to insert into the middle of the pile. And what does it read now, Lee?
Looks like it's about 66 or 7.
So it's kind of the ambient temperature out.
Yeah.
And what you'll find is when you put your thermometer in there, you'll come back in a day or two checking it, and it will increase in temperature. And also you'll find that the pile is going down and your thermometer is staying up. So it's a long 12-inch thermometer, and you want to keep inserting it so that down into the pile instead of the pile leaving. You can see the back of the bin is built with the hardware cloth, and then the top has a folding down top, which is great for shielding the rain. You want your hot compost built with so that it's just moist enough, like a wrung out sponge. We're gonna come over and look into this bin. As you can see, this compost has been going, and then next door there's another little pile, and we're gonna go ahead and turn this pile into the first pile.
Okay, so for this, I'm going to take the slats out.
I just
I like to put them in the same order.
Because you know that's where the way they fit.
Yeah. Yeah, I think this one just needs one more turn. Still nice and moist underneath the top layer.
So one of the things when you're turning, you want to check for the moisture, but and if you feel like you need to add moisture, you do. But also what you're doing is aerating the pile, which will put more air into the pile, and then you'll come back and check the temperature the following few days, and you'll see that the temperature rises. And once you've turned a pile, usually the fourth time, you'll see that it doesn't go up to 131, and so then you know you're at a point where you can just let it sit and cure. And then you're going to have black gold for your garden.
So what most people do in their own backyard is cold composting. Cold composting is simply a pile that you keep adding to. And most likely it's going to be things like kitchen waste and the coffee grounds and the tea bags and the crunched up eggshells, things like that that come out of your kitchen. You might have a few things out of your garden as well. Grass clippings are good. Dried leaves are great. But what the whole idea of a cold compost is that you don't have to really do anything to it. You're just adding material to it and letting it sit there. And then over time, usually about a year, it will decompose on its own, and you can kind of dig down to the bottom or just pull the top layer off, and you'll find all of this lovely crumbly stuff that is ready to go into your garden, and it's just beautiful stuff. And all you have to do is add your kitchen waste and your yard debris and your grass clippings and walk away. Easy.